Hey, and welcome to this in-depth tutorial on how we can get started using Ubuntu Apache Test Page. We're going to do it from an ARM template, we're going to do it from the CLI, and what we're going to try to make sure you learn is how you can use these ARM templates to start making changes to the parameters so that you don't have to log into the portal. You can do everything right from your command line, and you can even start committing these things to a repository in somewhere like Git, GitHub or Azure DevOps, so that you're able to keep these changes that you might make to an ARM template and effectively your Azure infrastructure. So let's go over step by step. Now, the first thing you'll want to do is to clone this repository to get started. Obviously, you need an Azure account to use Azure Cloud Shell. I'm going to show you that I have gone ahead already and cloned it in Azure Quick Start Templates. Cool. And so you've got all these different templates that we can work with, but specifically the one that we're going to want to use today is the Ubuntu Apache Test Page. So we'll cd into Ubuntu Apache Test Page. Cool. And we'll look at, here we are with all the files that are associated with it. You could see it also in here. So let's go ahead and just do a basic kind of deploy. So the first thing we'll do is create a resource group, and that's as simple as az group create, and then we'll specify the location and the name. We're going to call it a JDemo Apache. Simple enough. Mute it so you don't get any more of my little sounds. Cool, so now I have my new created resource group. That means that everything that I create will be within this resource group as long as I specify I want it to be created within there. And you can see I've created the location in central US. So what are we gonna do next? But we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna use the az group deploy command to go ahead, command to go ahead and create a new deployment. So we'll name the deployment Apache deploy, because this is going to be a Apache test page that you're going to actually be able to modify just from this command line. But to get started, I want to show you how we start making those changes via the command line. So obviously we've named it. The next thing we need to do is to next specify the resource group. So we'll say resource group, and we'll specify the one we just created, which is JDemo Apache. Okay, really cool. And then we need to specify the template file. And the template file, is the one that we have right here in our directory. Or we don't even need to say equal, we can just say Azure deploy.json. Cool. So let's see what happens. Oh, template file. Let's see. Just a typo. Okay, so no such directory. Azure. More typos. This is what happens when you are all watching me. Azure deploy.json. Hey, I got it right. So now it's asking me for some parameters. And where do these parameters come from? Well, they're all right now in here. And it's asking me for some specific parameters because that's the way this is set up. So I could actually go in and say admin username could be J. My password should be something complex. So I'm going to take this complex password that I keep around and we'll delete it after, and then a DNS name for public IP. I'm just gonna call it something real simple. How's about JDemo-Apache? Okay, cool. So let's see what happens after it's validating this. So invalid deployment. The template deployment failed with an error. Okay, it looks like the requested size for the resource is not available in the location central US. So let's find that resource that it's referring to. The parameter was the size. So the next step we're gonna do is, I know that some of these instances for that particular type exist in another location, and I don't necessarily want to modify anything else but just where it's going to be located. Because remember, all the resource group location is where it's storing metadata. It's not where your actual resources need to be. So how do we do that? So parameters. Like I said, when we were working with this, we had these parameters that we can modify. And what's really cool about that is that these parameters can do a ton of really interesting things, from specify what region we want to be in. So let's try doing that. So let's parameter, and we'll specify a region. And in this case, we'll just say that the location equals US, East US. Okay, and then we've got some other pretty cool variables that we can actually provide for these parameters. So as you can see, we can actually enter a page name, static title, and HTML to actually have that populated before we ever have to do anything else. So we could do that all right here from the command line. So let's go back to the Azure Deploy JSON, and let's look for the test page. So what does test page say here? Test page you want to create. So by default, it's going to put it in as index.html, but we don't want to modify that. Let's modify test page title. So test page title, we'll put here demo J, right? Why not? And then test page body, same thing. Let's put that there. And we'll go equal. And let's just say, instead of this is a test page, let's modify it to this is a really cool test page. Okay, so this should be everything that we need to specify we want our location to be East US, to populate the title, the test. And also, well, I don't want to fill out more stuff. I want to make sure that actually all the username, password, all that stuff is already filled out too. So let's put that in here as well. So I've got my username, my password, and the DNS for public name, and it'll just be jdestro-demo. So let's hit enter. Ooh, P. So let's see, what is the P from? Okay, so it looks like we'll probably have to put that in quotes. Not so hard. So we'll have to make sure that we're escaping this. So we'll just put this for, this is a really cool test page around. So we'll add quotations around the P tags. And that did it. So let's wait it out and we'll let this run. And once it's done, I'll show you the output, okay? Hey, so after a few minutes, it's done. As you can see, this is actually an output of all the information that was created. These are all the resources that are stored now and created by the ARM template. As you can see, we've got our name, everything associated with it. And I don't even want to show you this yet in the portal because it's not even worth it. But you can even see here are the artifacts to create this page. So here's the value for the FQDN. And let's just go ahead and copy this. Hey, there you go. This is a really cool test page. So that's how easy it is to start modifying, changing, doing things right from the control panel, or I should say not even from the control panel, but right from the CLI. And what's really great about this is that this is idempotent. So we can make changes to this, even though it's already been deployed. So let's go ahead. So let's run this command again. And this time, let's run it with, this is a really cool test page, 02. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm not even going to change this. I'm going to leave it all is. I'm just going to let it run. Okay, so we're back. And as you can see, our provisioning state is succeeded. Let's see. Oh, there it is. So we didn't even need to go in and do a redeployment or anything like that. All we had to do is run the command again with a parameter change. And it was idempotent, which means it's just going to change anything that we've specified as different. So the only thing we specified that was different between this command and this command was that 02, as you can see. So we could keep making changes. If we wanted to modify the template to attach another disk, we could do that, and it'll just attach the disk. That's the great thing about using ARM templates, is that you can codify everything that you want eventually to happen in Azure while you're just doing it in a template. So I'm going to give you some resources to use to be able to do this on your own in the blog post that you'll find. So if you have any questions, go ahead and leave them below in the comment section. And thanks for watching. I'll keep making these. If you keep getting in touch with me, you can find me on Twitter. It is at jdestro, as always. It's really easy to find me. If you would like to, shoot me a DM and I'll give you a help with any of this stuff if I can. So thanks again for watching, and keep using Azure.